Hello everyone, this is Paukshte Fashion Workshop. Today we continue working with the trench coat without a pattern. I drew the center back 5 cm away from the edge. I did it this way because there will be a vent on the back. The center back is absolutely straight. I drew it 5 cm away from the edge. Next, I need to draw a point 0, 4 cm down from the upper edge. Down from this point, I need to measure and mark the length of the back. You can use size triangle or ruler to draw the waistline at the right angle towards the edge. These are the neck base and the waistline. This is the back length measurement. I remind you that the length of the item on the front is 108 cm. That means that it should be made 105 cm long at the back. Please be very attentive. I'm sure that you managed to make such trench coats. There is nothing complicated in sewing them. This is the neck base, and this is the bottom. The length of the item at the back is 105 cm. This is the bottom, this is the waistline. This is the length of the back, 41 cm. Next, I need to divide this measurement in half, 20.5 cm. I need to draw this line to know where to make the armholes. To draw it, I need to divide the back length measurement in half. Next, I need to draw the hip line. I'll draw it 17 cm down from the waist. My measurement is actually 11 cm, but I don't ever use it. Let's have a look at what we got. This is the center back. I drew it 5 cm away from the edge because there will be a vent on the back. I drew the point 0, 4 cm down from the upper edge. Down from this point, I measured the length of the back. Then I divided this distance in half and drew one more line. The point 41 marks the waistline. I drew the hip line 17 cm down from it. The length of the item on the back is 105 cm. I've already told you how to measure the distance between the waist and the hips. 17 cm for low height, 18-19 cm for medium height, 20-22 cm for tall people. My hips are usually very high. They should be here, but I don't like to show it. This is why I drew them 17 cm down from the waist. I hope that everything is clear so far. I need to make the back 1 cm tighter on the waist. You can make it 1.5 cm tighter. It depends on your body. Anyway, the trench coat shouldn't be close-fitting. My back width measurement is 41 cm. That means that one half of it is 20.5 cm. I need to measure and mark it here. I remind you that I'm drawing just one half of the back. Do everything just like I show you. Next, I need to measure 8 cm to the left from the point 0. This is the width of my neckline. It should also be 3 cm high. 8 cm and 3 cm. These are regular measurements. Slim people can make it 7 cm wide. Necklines and size stretch coats should be pretty wide. I think that maybe I'll make it even wider after fitting. Now I can draw the back neckline. I need to draw a horizontal line here.
Вот этот уровень на одной
горизонтальной. It's very important that these two points should be on the same level.
Отложить вниз.
Next, need to measure and mark 2.5 centimeters down from this point.
Сантиметра.
This is the point 2.5. You can draw it 2 centimeters lower.
Но это уже как бы
this is the slope of the back shoulder.
Это зависит от того, сколько свободы мы хотим. Вот я хочу 2.5. Верхнюю точку начала плеча.
Next, I need to draw a shoulder line through these points. After that, I need to measure and mark 30 centimeters on this line. This is the length of the shoulder. This is how the drop shoulders will look like. Let's move on to the next measurements. One half of the bust measurement is 60 centimeters, so 1/4 of it is 30 centimeters. I need to measure and mark 30 centimeters here. The trench coat should be wide, so I'll mark 32 centimeters. One half of the hips measurement is 59 centimeters, so 1/4 is 29.5 centimeters. I also add 2 centimeters here. One half of the hips measurement is 50 centimeters, so 1/4 is 25. I'm not going to draw the sides in this way. I'll make the line more smooth. The waist will be pretty wide. This is one of the features of trench coats. They are usually not close-fitting. If you want the trench coat to fit you closer, you can make a small tuck here. Side seam should be almost straight. I need to mark the width of the hips on the bottom line. Notice that I'm not even measuring it. I just mark the needed point with the finger. I want the trench coat to be straight. I can see now that there won't be enough fabric for a skirt left. This is how the side seam looks like now. The vent will start 34 centimeters down from the waist. I'll sign it. It can be even longer. I like high vents. This is the center back. Next, I need to draw sleeves. The distance between the waist and the bust lines is 21 centimeters. I need to draw a short line 6 centimeters down from the bust line. You can make the sleeves as wide as you want. I'll show you how my trench will look like for you to decide if you like it or not. Watch what I'm doing. This is the shoulder. I need to draw a line down from this point. I should draw it at the right angle. Stop drawing at the point where it crosses this line. Draw a short long line here to connect this point with the side seam. The pattern for the back is ready. Such drop shoulder is very convenient. I need to pin the two layers of fabric together. I will make the pattern for the front on the basis of the pattern for the back. I hope to have enough fabric for a skirt left, but I still need to make lapels, waistband, yokes, big collar. I hope there will be enough fabric for these details.
Как-то точно это все не получится.
Учитесь работать с этим. The technique I'm showing you now is very useful.
Это очень ценно, то, что я вам даю.
Just imagine how good this trench coat will look like. I need to add 1 centimeter to the center back. not forget to add some for an overcast. 3 centimeters will be enough. I'll even add a bit less. This point marks the center of this piece of fabric. I will make the front on the other side. I'm glad that we are learning to work without patterns. The technique is very simple, but at the same time useful. I don't have anything to wear my shoes with. Now we can start working with the front. You already know that when sewing something without patterns, I make a pattern for the back first, and then a pattern for the front on its basis. Next, I'll make a pattern for the front and tack the trench coat. I will show you everything very thoroughly. I drew the center front. Here it is. I drew it 8 centimeters away from the edge. I did it because this is going to be a double-breasted item. If it was a single-breasted item, 3 centimeters would be enough. Next, I need to match the center back and the center front. I remind you that the center back is slightly round at the waist. This is why you need to match the beginning and the end. These are the center back and the center front. Here they are as well. They should match. You know what is the best thing about this technique? You don't need to measure or calculate anything. It's very easy to make a pattern for the front. First, I need to raise the front shoulder for 2.5 centimeters here and 1 centimeter here. If it was an item with a deep neckline, the front neckline would have been drawn this way. I don't want to make it that deep. This is how the collar looks like. Now I can start cutting. I don't need to measure anything else. You can make the front neckline as deep as you want. I remind you that this part of the shoulder should be higher than this one. The technique is almost the same as when making clothes with dolman sleeves. I think that my outfit will be gorgeous. Pencil skirt, shirt, trench coat. I will find something else to wear with my shoes. I don't need to draw or measure anything. I just need to make a notch on the waistline. I still need to make a collar, waistband, and yokes. This is the back. This is the front. This is the center front. Do not forget to make a notch on the waistline. That's it. Today I showed you how to cut a trench coat without a pattern. Next time I'll show you how to make a collar, yokes and waistband. I will also tack the trench coat. That's all for today. Be different and beautiful. My name is Paukshte Irina. Subscribe to my channel, write comments, share videos, press the like and the bell buttons. I really need your support. Thank you. Goodbye.